The PSU banks today are on fire. I'll ask my producer to show you all the various stocks that are flying in trade. And that's all following the SBI's announcement to introduce a two-tier savings rate. Poonam Sahni joining us with that story. Poonam, it's been a while since we've seen the savings rate being deregulated and SBI taking the lead in cutting the savings rate.
In fact, yes, SBI mentioned in the con call today itself that in fact they've gone ahead and cut the savings rate for the first time since 2011 itself. And in fact, they did have a choice to go ahead and cut the MCLR or go ahead and cut the savings deposit rates. And what they have done is they've gone ahead and cut the savings deposit rates basically for savings accounts. Of less than 1 crore, they would now be offering a rate of nearly around 3.5%, and over 1 crore it would be 4%. What they're also mentioning is that according to them, the real interest rates in the system are fairly high, and they have gone ahead and now gone cut the savings deposit rates. They did not mention the exact impact on the margins, but ballpark calculations from most of the analysts do suggest that the impact on the margins, a 50 bips cut in the savings rate could lead to an impact of the impact in terms of anywhere between 10 to 20 odd bips. In fact, Morgan Stanley suggests that the impact on SBI itself could be nearly around 14 odd bips. And CLSA also mentions that the sector funding cost, in fact, would be coming down by nearly around 15 to 20 bips. In fact, SBI also mentioned that post the note ban, nearly 60% of the deposits have gone off. These are the deposits that they had garnered during the note ban. So 40% does remain retained in the system. They're also mentioning that they do see a marginal impact in terms of the CASA ratio, and they're expecting a deposit growth of somewhere around 13%. They're also stating that the credit growth in the system still remains fairly muted, and yes, they would only be taking a call in terms of further cutting their lending rates post the RBI policy, or in fact they're stating that they may again review it in the month of August itself. So clearly it does mention that there is further scope of lending rates to come down in the system. Competition definitely is fairly high again in the system. The interest rates would come down. SBI also believes that they do feel the interest rates should come down further, at least by 50 bips over FY18, and they do state that probably interest rate, lower interest rates are still needed to spur the further corporate credit growth. In fact, we also spoke to SBI. Let's listen in to what they had to say.
Credit growth has been quite muted so far. They all are the numbers which are available in the public domain, right? And deposits, our YOY growth as of now
is close to 13%.
Close to 13%. So we are hopeful that we'll continue to maintain that YOY growth.
And in that, the CASA growth is significantly higher than the fixed deposit.
So we are not expecting that the CASA ratio will go down significantly, because as I mentioned earlier, that it is a savings account as well as it is a utility account. And the facilities which we offer, and the network reach as well as the electronic channels, digital channels, ATM network. So from that perspective, there is still a strong incentive for our customers to maintain their savings bank account with us. It is the convenience, it is the safety, and it is the trust. So there is a combination of so many factors which come into play. And I'm not anticipating as far as CASA ratio is concerned or savings account ratio is concerned, there will be any major impact.